Oscar-licious.
Some of the most powerful weapons in PUBG are the bolt-action sniper rifles due to their high damage and one-shot kill potential. With that said, bolt-action rifles share the battlefield with their slightly less powerful cousins, the DMRs, or dedicated marksman rifle. Both types of weapons are a must for players who are looking to round out their secondary weapon slot, but the question remains, which one is better? I don't necessarily feel the need to go into the different damage modifiers for all the different rifles since you can find these types of breakdowns already, so instead, we're going to look at both types of weapons and go over which one you should prioritize and what situation favors one over the other. Let's start by looking at the bolt action rifles. This category is populated by the Kar-98 and the M24. Both are 7.76 caliber rifles with a base of 5 rounds of capacity. The M24 has the ability to be equipped with an extended mag, increasing its capacity to 7 rounds, while the Kar-98 is limited only just to 5. Both have the ability to be equipped with a cheek pad to eliminate degrees of weapon sway, yet the Kar-98 has the option to equip ammo loops, which increases its base reload speed, making it the preferred stock attachment by most since the ability to hold your breath with the shift key provides enough stability to prioritize reload speed over a slight increase in stability. In terms of which bolt-action rifle is better, the M24 beats out the Kar-98 in damage, but only by around 5-10% more. This difference is pretty negligible considering both are capable of delivering lethal headshots against enemies wearing level 1 and level 2 helmets. Neither are capable of dealing lethal blows against level 3 helmets, however, reserving that power exclusively for the AWM, which I chose to exclude from this video since it's an airdrop weapon, and in terms of comparing it to DMRs, it shares the same pros and cons as the other two bolt-action rifles. As for the DMRs, there are 4 different variations of this weapon, yet one is the QBU, which is a 5.56 caliber rifle exclusive only to Sandhawk. The others are the Mini 14, which is another 5.56 caliber rifle, the SKS, and the SLR, which are both 7.76. All these weapons share the same attachments with some slight variations. The SKS and the SLR have the luxury of being able to equip the cheek pad, again increasing the overall weapon handling, but the SKS also has the added benefit of being able to attach a grip. This pairs nicely with the vertical or lightweight grip since it aids in reducing the weapon's recoil. Otherwise, all the other barrel and magazine attachments can be used across each one and can even be equipped with the same barrel and magazines that the assault rifles use. Unfortunately, this only works for the DMRs and not the bolt action rifles, nor do the assault rifles have the ability to use sniper rifle attachments. So, if the bolt action sniper rifle has the ability to one-shot an enemy up to a level 2 helmet, does that make them superior to the DMR? This question seems like an obvious yes, but what I think needs to be taken into consideration is context. What I mean by this is, each weapon in the game has moments in which it is more powerful or more effective. Take the shotgun for example. Whether it's the double barrel or the pump action shotgun, both have the capacity to deal one-shot kills on a player. Regardless if the other player has an SMG or an assault rifle, both of which boast a much higher damage per second, under the right circumstances, that shotgun will win out every time due to its effectiveness at close range. Through this lens, we can examine both sniper rifles and DMRs to see which one is the most effective. What makes the DMR great is their ability to fire high damage rounds at a rapid, semi-automatic rate. Unlike the bolt-action rifles, which require a new round to be chambered after each shot. This means in situations where you need to fire multiple shots quickly, such as tracking an enemy across an open field or in a vehicle, the DMR should be your preferred weapon of choice. A good tip when trying to hit a moving target with the DMR is to try to aim for the body instead of the head. Since your shots won't be able to kill a target at full health with a headshot anyway, you're better off aiming for the largest part of the body since you're going to have to hit multiple shots in order to get the kill. Bolt-action sniper rifles, on the other hand, are most dominant in peak battles with another player. As mentioned, the DMRs are unable to kill a player with a single headshot, unlike the bolt-action rifles. So in these cases, the bolt-action has a massive advantage since it only takes one good shot to kill a player instead of the 2 or more the DMR would require. I definitely would advise anyone taking these types of fights to be aware of what your opponent has and to avoid taking a hot wad to the chops. One last tip for players who choose to take the bolt-action rifle as their secondary over a DMR is to be aware of the necessity to rechamber a round after each shot is fired. I know I mentioned this in the pros and cons section, but it's something many players often forget about after firing the weapon and immediately holstering it to swap to another weapon. What this leads to are moments later in the game where the opportunity presents itself to take out another player with a quick headshot, only to have to pause and rechamber a round. Potentially losing out on a kill this way can be very frustrating, so make sure your sniper rifles are always good to go at a moment's notice. I hope this video has been helpful to any player wondering which secondary weapon they should be prioritizing. At the end of the day, each player should choose whatever weapon they find to better fit their playstyle, but I felt it was important to highlight some of the strengths and weaknesses of each so that you could be informed as to which situation benefited each weapon. I personally find the assault rifle slash bolt action combo to fit my playstyle the best, since I'm more than likely going to have either a 4x or a 6x scope that I can swap onto my AR and use as a budget DMR if need be. In other cases where I know I'm going to be taking a lot of open fights with limited cover, the DMR like the Mini 14 with its high bullet velocity makes for a satisfying and responsive weapon to shoot. Regardless of whichever you choose, having either one in your inventory, along with an assault rifle or an SMG, makes for a well-rounded kit that ensures you're effective at both close and long-range engagements.